like a seagoing professional, Antarctica is always one that you kind of just want to check off your list.
Just the sheer remoteness of it pushes the boundaries for most vessels and for most crew.
What does it take to bring Falkor 2 to the Antarctic? Well, it has to be planning.
It's the seventh continent. It's the hardest continent to get to. It puts a lot of stress on you in ways that you probably haven't ever actually felt.
Long and short, you have the preparations of the ship and you have the preparations of the people on board.
Our perspective has been to ensure that all the crew are safe and warm, to provide winter gear, to be able to be warm, to conduct all of their duties on board. So that's been a challenge because we spend 90% of our time out at sea. When we get to port and we actually have land-based opportunities to get provisions on board, we have a very short space of time to be able to do that.
The distance away from the nearest supermarket or shop and making sure we've got everything on board just to make sure we don't run out of anything in the middle of Antarctica.
Another challenge of the Antarctic is the navigation. The charts for the area, sometimes pretty sparse. The data that they're based on could be quite old, and we have to revert to more traditional methods of navigation.
A lot of the sensors that work fine in normal temperatures, you have to adjust them in a way so that they're compatible working near freezing. I wish it would just be like an Antarctica dial for all of our sensors that we can just press a button and have it be ready.
We also do need to take on an ice pilot in order to navigate in these waters. So we have an ice pilot with us for the entire cruise.
To get the ship to Antarctica, there's no way about it. You've got to cross the Southern Ocean, and in our case, that's going to be the Drake Passage. It's well renowned for whatever weather that can be thrown at you, being thrown at you, and then some. It takes more than just a big and strong ship to get across the Drake Passage. It also takes some pretty strong stomachs as well.
There's only one way to find out.
Are you wrapped up nice and warm?
Yep. There's about 2 inches of water all over the deck.
You got your Wellingtons on, Jimbo?
Yep, I've got my Wellingtons.
The sea doesn't always want to play with you. A very basic task that is easy to do in the tropics is very difficult when your hands are cold, your brain is numb, and then the waves come up and throw you off. The waves basically came up and splashed us from the back, and it didn't do it just once, it did it 4 times.
You guys all right, Jimbo?
Yep, we're good.
So, season's greetings from Antarctica.
It's my first time seeing snow. First time in more than 10 years of being a seafarer.
I remember when we saw our first iceberg, we were so excited.
We have visual, yeah, two icebergs.
I think it was at lunchtime. So I was just having my lunch, and then I was like that in shorts and t-shirts. And I ran outside and I was like that, right, go and get a picture with this. So I'm in my shorts and t-shirt with my first iceberg.
There was a lot of excitement. Little did we know that was just the beginning.
It There's just something beautiful about lonely, desolate places. It's something I've always dreamed of doing, is going there and diving under the ice. They asked me, do you think you'd be okay flying an ROV under the ice? And I was thinking, like, they're gonna have to try and stop me from doing it, like.
I was able to get onto one of the small boats and go look around the little icebergs and the, you know, the glowing blue ice and penguins. It was fantastic.
Getting to go on the Zodiac and the workboat, shuttling scientists to and from the beach or to and from ice floes. Yeah, honestly, that's been the highlight for me. Most of the time we're in the middle of the ocean, no obstacles. Sometimes we don't see anything for weeks. So this is something different. And you know, it's like playing a video game. You're just out there dodging ice.
Antarctica weather in general makes it a very challenging place to operate. And we have had a lot of challenges. As an example, we normally make a plan about mapping in order to basically try and make what amounts to straight line. In this case, we're dodging icebergs. And if you look at the map and the way we move, it's all over the place. And you look like we're wondering what in the world's going on. But if you actually are sitting there, it makes a lot more sense because there's an iceberg here, there's an iceberg there.
It's the epitome of adventure, thrill, excitement, and especially as a research vessel, being able to get out there and explore and present groundbreaking data to the rest of the world that hopefully will leave a legacy for future generations to come.
It's so important, I think. You know, there's big restrictions when it comes to ocean research. So to be able to provide a platform like this that can do such a broad scope of operations, I think is really important to the community.
No, yo creo que ir a la Antártica es un sueño. Y el tener la oportunidad de ir con un barco de investigación y con un fin específico de investigación, de descubrir, de buscar, no sé, la solución a problemas. Eso no es simplemente fui y ya está. O sea, tiene algo más profundo allí.